President of the Republic of Kosovo, honorable ministers, advisors, members of the press. It is with great pleasure that I accepted the kind invitation of my dear friend, the President of the Republic of Kosovo, to visit your country. On behalf of my husband and my delegation, I thank Her Excellency and extend my heartfelt appreciation for the warm welcome we have received here in Pristina. My delegation and I have just had a cordial and constructive meeting with Her Excellency and her delegation, where I conveyed Malta's commitment to continue building and strengthening bilateral relations between our two countries. We are very pleased to have this opportunity to consolidate the already existing strong relations which gained momentum during these last months. I am convinced that in the course of this short state visit, further understanding of our potential, development of political, economic, trade, cultural, and social relations will be achieved. Malta recognized Kosovo's independence from the start and has since been actively supporting, particularly through the EU framework, the people of Kosovo on the road towards fulfilling their European Union aspirations. I am confident that, as a result of this state visit, ties between Malta and Kosovo will continue to strengthen, and Malta will continue to extend its expertise and experience to Kosovo in its way ahead towards European integration. In fact, Malta has welcomed with great satisfaction the signing of the stabilization and association agreement between the European Union and Kosovo. Malta notes that this important agreement is definitely a positive step towards integration with the EU. Malta is also determined to continue to support Kosovo to establish further its rightful place in the international forum. A positive step towards the enhancement of bilateral relations between Malta and Kosovo is the successful conclusion of a second memorandum of understanding between our two foreign ministries covering cooperation in various sectors, most notably political consultation, economic, social, and cultural initiatives that would build upon the previous similar agreement that was signed in December 2013. Whilst noting the progressive road ahead for Kosovo towards achieving a fully functioning market economy, Malta notes and commends the government's program to strengthen fiscal planning and to effectively implement the necessary fiscal regulations. On the other hand, we acknowledge that visa liberalization is a prominent and tangible outcome for countries wishing to deepen their relations with the European Union. I believe that visa liberalization will definitely stimulate all levels of development and will bring Kosovo closer to its European perspective. Within this context, Malta supports the launch of a visa liberalization process. Malta remains committed to assist Kosovo in its process to develop its institutions in preparation of the EU membership. Malta can share its long-standing experience in institution building by providing the necessary training of public officials. I also discussed with Her Excellency the possibility of students from Kosovo Foreign Ministry to further their studies in the diplomacy at the Mediterranean Academy of Diplomatic Studies in my country, which enjoys a very strong international reputation in the training of diplomatic skills. The conclusion of the Memorandum of Understanding between the Maltese Diplomatic Institution and Diplomatic Academy of the Republic of Kosovo, signed on the 30th November 2015, is a very significant step in the strengthening of bilateral cooperation in this field too. Malta also looks forward to the participation of Kosovar students to courses at the International Maritime Organization in my country that trains legal professionals in the relevant areas of international maritime law, including the law of the sea, maritime, environmental law, and shipping law. I eagerly look forward for bilateral trade between Malta and Kosovo to be developed. Malta already proposed to embark on a program of trade cooperation. In this regard, we suggested a business delegation hopefully led by you, my dear friend, Your Excellency the President of the Republic of Kosovo, will come to Malta to assess on this on-site what Malta has to offer for the potential development of economic and trade relations. I commend the efforts of the very first ambassador of Kosovo to Malta, who has contributed in no small way towards consolidating the basis for future collaboration between our two friendly countries. On another note, I would like to publicly express my heartfelt appreciation to you, my dear friend, Madam President, for the donation, I am told, of a statue of the Blessed Mother Teresa, who is much revered by the Maltese people. We look forward to erecting the statue of our dear Mother Teresa on the historic occasion of her sainthood. Finally, on the eve of Kosovo's 8th anniversary of the declaration of its independence, I would like to augur all Kosovars peace and prosperity and good health to my dear friend, the President of the Republic of Kosovo. Thank you.